why while the governor officially extended his stay-home order until the end of May, he revealed that some of his restrictions will likely remain in place well into July. This afternoon, he laid out his four-phase plan for reopening the state. Inslee says we're about to enter phase one with construction and fishing opening back up. And he says by mid-May, curbside retail services, auto sales, and drive-in spiritual services may resume. Phase two would include camping and the reopening of barbershops and some restaurants with limited seating. Phase three would allow for events of up to 50 people. Phase four, 50-plus events. But Inslee said at least 3 weeks would need to pass in between each of those phases. While he says that will be painful, he says the state must be careful.
This is bad enough once. We should not take the risk to do this twice. And we have to make decisions based on hard-headed data and science and not wishes when it comes to life itself.
I asked the governor if he thought people were getting frustrated and fed up and might start to refuse to comply with the order and open up businesses as we have seen. He said he knows people are frustrated. He knows this is painful, but he says he remains confident the state will continue to comply with his order. Live in Olympia, Drew Mickelson, King 5 News.
So, Drew, quickly, the governor also talked about technology and how successful telecommuting has been. But what about the 1 in 5 workers in our state seeking unemployment? Retail, restaurant workers, so many small businesses. Did the governor have any concrete news for all those people who want to get back to work?
He knows those numbers. Those are part of the numbers that he's looking at. And he says the state is trying to help. He has been talking about state beefing up the assistance that's being offered. And he also is saying, look, we are starting to reopen some things. And by the end of this new month, auto sales may resume. Some restaurants might be able to open up in June. So he says we are trying to get things open. But at this point, it's trying to balance lives with livelihood and economics. And he says right now, preserving life is a bigger priority for him.
All right, Drew. Of course, we'll talk with you in our next hour. Thank you.